On Politicking today, we are rerunning the exclusive interview with the new Minister for Education and Sports, Janet Museveni. She was among those who were sworn in on Tuesday. I caught up with her earlier, talking her priorities in the first 100 days and challenges growing up as a girl child in Uganda.
My desire, I would like to say, is to say that I'd like to see Uganda really get its place back in the region, get the education back the standard that we all desire, that all parents of Uganda desire for their children. I would like all of us, however, to agree to work together, because they shouldn't think that I can do it alone or the government will do it alone. Ugandans need to take responsibility for our education standards so that all of us really can help the sector to come up again. And I have so much faith in my heart and confidence that we can do it when everybody plays their part. We will get our education where we need it to be.
I, Janet Kataha Museveni, swear in the name of the Almighty God that I will be faithful and bear true allegiance to the Republic of Uganda, and that I will preserve, protect, and defend the Constitution. So help me God.
So many young ladies see you as a role model, and I would like to know, how did you grow up through all these challenges of being a girl child in Uganda?
I grew up in a rural area, first of all, and my children think that it's very funny that all the parents of my generation talk about their school experience as if everybody walked long distances to go to school, and they had to cross swamps to get to school, and they had to do so much that children don't think they are supposed to do in this time and age. But that's part of my experience. I walked long distances to school. I used to walk 4 miles to school and 4 miles back home. Sometimes I would get on a bus and get home, or get a relative to give me a ride on a bicycle to get home. That's in a primary school, and that's when I was young. I was very young. But girls or children had to do that to get education at all at that time. But there is something that I was even sharing this morning, because we were in a seminar where we were talking about challenges that children face these days. Where I grew up, when I grew up, the village was really a place that took care of all the children in the village. And I've been talking about a proverb that is said to be African, which says that it takes a village to bring up a child. The whole village really took the responsibility of any child. No woman would meet you on the street misbehaving or wasting time or playing in the mud or doing something at school time and leave you there. They would actually beat you up and take you to school or send you back home. And your mother would be grateful that somebody did that. But these days, the children are at risk because nobody cares. Because the village don't care. Everybody cares for their own children and God for us all. That's how children grow at a risk. Because the children get lost, because children get accidents, because they are taken away and kidnapped, because nobody's looking out for them. But when I grew up, The environment in which we grew up was different. Every mother in the village was a mother of every child, whether they were your biological children or not. That's what children miss presently.
Now, I also represent Urban TV, which is a very young audience, and these youth today are pretty much concerned over this prevalent strikes in universities, institutions of higher learning. How do you think this problem can be solved such that we have maybe better ways of solving problems in universities other than striking?
I think the way to solve problems like that is to try as much as possible to hold dialogues, if it is the teaching staff, with government leaders, to discuss what problems there are at universities. If it is the students, even the students, to discuss these problems with the teaching staff at universities, if it requires government's input, to have government to be present and discuss issues and find real solutions instead of always striking. Striking, which sometimes makes those young people get accidents and they get harmed on the way, they get all sorts, they destroy buildings and things like that. It's absolutely unnecessary. But sometimes it's just what is happening in the world, which we are part of. Our young people watch what is happening in the media, on TV, other places in the world. And they think that's the trend, that that's what students do. But they don't need to do that. And they can be discouraged, and they can be talked to, and I think solutions can be found easily than having to go that direction.
Again, matters of the girl child, which we all know are very close to your heart. Mm. What programs can we expect to support the girl child in the near future?
Well, it depends what age the girls are. I think we need to look at many aspects where girls get problems. If sometimes children who can't get education can get scholarships, if there are such scholarships. Those who are looking for employment, we can look, the government has many programs now that can help young people to get self-employed. We can look at that. So it depends where the girl is and what age they are. But I think there's some solutions that can be found if given a chance.
And while growing up in early school, did you ever imagine you'd become the first lady?
No, not in my wildest dreams. Not at all. I didn't. Honestly, now this is true, I didn't. But here I am, you may be one day or so.
Let's now find out what stories get the thumbs up or thumbs down from our lineup today on the Waki and Dop. And the Dop goes to the First Lady, Janet Museveni, who's been sworn in as the Minister for Education and Sports, together with the rest of the cabinet members, for saying congratulations.
The streets is watching.
You are watching PM Live.
Now you've listened to the sneak peek, but what are your expectations from the new Minister of Education and Sports, Janet Museveni? It's time to connect.
We'll be right back.
And it's a wrap. Thanks for being part of the show. See you again tomorrow right here on Urban TV at the same time. For now, let's keep those conversations going on Twitter at Urban TV Uganda or Facebook at Urban Television. You can also share directly with me. Follow me on Twitter. My handle is at Raz Athman, or you can like my page, Razia Athman, that's on Facebook. Cheers.